on the monad. The monad is the non-spatial source of number. It is called monad because of its stability, since it preserves the specific identity of any number with which it is conjoined. For instance, 3 times 1 equals 3, 4 times 1 equals 4. See how the approach of the monad to these numbers preserved the same identity and did not produce a different number. Everything has been organized by the monad, because it contains everything potentially. For even if they are not yet actual, nevertheless the monad holds seminally the principles which are within all numbers, including those which are within the dyad. For the monad is even and odd and even odd, linear and plane and solid, cubical and spherical, and in the form of pyramids from those with 4 angles to those with an indefinite number of angles. Perfect and over-perfect and defective, proportionate and harmonic, prime and incomposite, and secondary, diagonal and side, and it is the source of every relation, whether one of equality or inequality. Every compound of plurality or every subdivision is given form by the monad. For the decad is 1, and the kiliad is 1, and again 1/10 is 1, and 1/1000 is 1, and so on for all the subdivisions ad infinitum. In each of these cases there is the same monad in terms of form, yet different monads in respect of quantity, because it produces itself out of itself, as well as producing them, just as if it were the principle of the universe and the nature of things. And because it maintains everything and forbids whatever it is present in to change, it alone of all numbers resembles the providence which preserves everything, and is most particularly suited both to reflect the principle of God and to be likened to him, insofar as it is closest to him. Furthermore, the monad produces itself and is produced from itself, since it is self-sufficient and has no power set over it and is everlasting, and it is evidently the cause of permanence, just as God is thought to be in the case of natural things, and to be the preserver and maintainer of natures. On the dyad. Adding dyad to dyad is equivalent to multiplying them. Adding them and multiplying them have the same result. And yet in all other cases multiplication is greater than addition. Among the virtues, they liken it to courage, for it has already advanced into action. Hence too they used to call it daring and impulse, and they called it movement, generation, change, division, length, multiplication, addition, kinship, relativity, the ratio in proportionality, for the relation of 2 numbers is of every conceivable form. So the dyad alone remains without form, and without the limitation of being contained by 3 terms and proportionality, and is opposed and contrary to the monad beyond all other numerical terms, as matter is contrary to God, or body to incorporeality, and is as it were the source and foundation of the diversity of numbers, and hence resembles matter, and the dyad is all but contrasted to the nature of God in the sense that it is considered to be the cause of things changing and altering, while God is the cause of sameness and unchanging stability. The dyad gets its name from passing through or asunder, for the dyad is the first to have separated itself from the monad, whence also it is called daring, for when the monad manifests unification, the dyad steals in and manifests separation. It rules over the category of relativity too, either by virtue of its ratio as regards the monad, which is double, or by virtue of its ratio as regards the next number after it, which is sesquialta, and those ratios are the roots of the ratios which extend infinitely in either direction, with the consequence that the dyad is also in this respect the source of multiplication and division. The dyad would be the midpoint between plurality, which is regarded as falling under the triad, and that which is opposed to plurality, which falls under the monad. Hence it simultaneously has the properties of both. It is the property of one, as source, to make something more by addition than by the blending power of multiplication, and that is why 1 plus 1 is more than 1 times 1, and it is the property of plurality, on the other hand, as product, to do the opposite, for it makes something more by multiplication than by addition, for plurality is no longer like a source, but each number is generated out of another and by blending, and that is why 3 times 3 is more than 3 plus 3. And while the monad and the triad have opposite properties, the dyad is, as it were, the mean, and it will admit the properties of both at once, as it occupies the midpoint between them. And we say that the mean between what is greater and what is smaller is what is equal. Therefore, equality lies in this number alone. Therefore, the product of its multiplication will be equal to the sum of its addition. For 2 plus 2 equals 2 times 2. Hence, they used to call it equal. The dyad is clearly formless, because the infinite sequence of polygons arise in actuality from triangularity and the triad, while as a result of the monad everything is together in potential, and no rectilinear figure consists of two straight lines or two angles. So what is indefinite and formless falls under the dyad alone. On the triad. The triad has a special beauty and fairness beyond all numbers, primarily because it is the very first to make actual the potentialities of the monad. Oddness, perfection, proportionality, unification, limit. For 3 is the first number to be actually odd, since in conformity with its descriptions it is more than equal, and has something more than the equal in another part. And it is special in respect of being successive to the two sources and a system of them in both. At any rate, it is perfect in a more particular way than other numbers to which consecutive numbers from the monad to the tetrad are found to be equal. I mean, that is, the monad, triad, hexad, and decad. The monad, as basic number of this series, is equal to the monad. The triad is equal to the monad and dyad. The hexad is equal to the monad, dyad, and triad. The decad is equal to the monad, dyad, triad, and tetrad. So the triad seems to have something extra in being successive to those to which it is also equal. The triad is called prudence and wisdom, that is, when people act correctly as regards the present, look ahead to the future, and gain experience from what has already happened in the past. So wisdom surveys the three parts of time, and consequently knowledge falls under the triad. They call the triad piety, hence the name triad is derived from terror, that is, fear and caution. The triad, the first odd number, is called perfect by some, because it is the first number to signify the totality, beginning, middle, and end. When people exalt extraordinary events, they derive words from the triad and talk of thrice blessed and thrice fortunate. Prayers and libations are performed 3 times. Triangles both reflect and are the first substantiation of being plane, and there are 3 kinds of triangle: equilateral, isosceles, and scalene. Moreover, there are 3 rectilinear angles: acute, obtuse, and right, and there are 3 parts of time. Among the virtues, they likened it to moderation, for it is commensurability between excess and deficiency. Moreover, the triad makes 6 by the addition of the monad, dyad, and itself, and 6 is the first perfect number. They call it friendship, and peace, and further, harmony, and unanimity, for these are all cohesive and unifactory of opposites and dissimilars. Hence they also call it marriage, and there are also 3 ages in life,